quite curious. I mean, your father, of course, he's made history by fighting the dictatorship of former the late Ferdinand Marcos. You yourself has also made that stand. Mm-hmm. And you have many observers saying, what's it like that Senator Koko is campaigning with Imee? Mm-hmm. How could you share the stage with her?
Number one, I've gotten used to it. Okay, because we are both carried by HNP, where I am also a guest candidate, because that's not my party. And she's Imee Marcos is the guest candidate of PDP Laban. Upon the suggestion and nomination of our party chairman, President Duterte. So I respect the decision of President Duterte to expand the 5 official PDP Laban by adding 7 guest candidates. Mm-mm. So we they are welcome to join our rallies, and Imee has been joining. So I've gotten used to it. And then,
but I'm curious, course, may boundaries ka ba, Senator Koko? Is there something you won't do with Imee? Because I researched in 2013, you refused to share the campaign stage with Miguel Zubiri under UNA. Mm-mm. And so you ran with Pinoy then. Mm-mm. And of course, naka-falling out ka noon with Vice President Binay for refusing. Mm-mm. But you're not refusing now. I mean, you are...
Different issue.
Okay.
I mean, different
issue. Go ahead.
Yung Imee Marcos in 2007, you know, that was a... There was an election protest, ganun. So iba po yung issue na yon. But with Imee, if you ask me about the Marcos martial law years, and if you ask me if these were good years or beneficial years for the country, I would still say no, because of the suppression of democracy. We had no basic freedoms. Yun po yon. But that is still going to be my stand when you ask me my opinion about the Marcos martial law years. So, but I can campaign with Imee because she has been nominated by the president.
Mm-mm. I'm quite curious. I mean, since you said honesty should be an issue, and you're known to be a straight guy, huh? Mm. I mean, you're like, you know, you say it like it is. Should Imee already set the record straight? UP said she did not graduate from UP. Princeton said she didn't graduate from Princeton. And in all your campaign footage, she avoids the media when they want to ask her that question. Does it matter?
We were sharing a table. We were having merienda, and I think a local media practitioner was able to approach her and ask her. No? And then she said, I will be issuing soon a statement about that. So. Let her be. Let us allow Imee to settle the issue, answer the question.
So you can work with Imee if you both win?
Of course.
You can.
Because when I joined the Senate, Bongbong was also a senator. So and he was the chair of the local government committee. So I'm also interested in, you know, reviewing the local government code written by my father, improving on it. So I was able, I worked with him.
Okay.